At the moment, every day, fishing community lose about 80 million worth income. And also, by now, all the foreign orders for the fishing fish has been stopped, which will cost about 300 million rupees within this period. The fishermen at the moment don't have any income.
Just recently, our motherland faced what is known to be Sri Lanka's worst marine ecological disaster of all time. As we all know, the MV Express Pearl cargo ship carrying many harmful chemicals, including 23 tons of nitric acid, ethanol, and sodium methoxide, caught on fire due to a chemical leak just 9.5 nautical miles away from the Colombo port. The ship was also transporting linear low-density plastic pellets and low-density plastic pellets that come in a microform of nurdles. These are purchased to produce bigger plastic materials. Millions of these plastic nurdles washed ashore, turning our beautiful beaches into a plastic wasteland in just a matter of days.
And our waters are abundant with marine wildlife. We have 5 out of the 7 species of sea turtles coming into our beaches to nest. And these animals, they mistake these pellets for food. And when they consume it, it can block their digestive tracts and it can make them feel unnaturally full. And we know that pellets absorb toxins in the water. So when these animals consume the pellets, the toxins can also leach into their bodies and just pass throughout the food chain.
Since these microplastic nurdles are very lightweight, they are bound to spread to various different areas of the country with the wind, which can then be consumed by terrestrial animals as well. Apart from that, the gender of the sea turtle hatchlings is dependent on the temperature in the sand. So, when these plastic nurdles get stuck inside the sand, there is a question as to whether the temperature and the permeability of the sand would change, affecting the gender of the hatchlings. If this issue results in the birth of more female sea turtle hatchlings, it could impinge adversely on turtle conservation. And what's heartbreaking is that all of the species of sea turtles that visit our beaches to lay eggs are endangered. Especially the hawksbill sea turtles are reported to be critically endangered. There are also many species of whales that are loyal to our waters and could be severely impacted by the chemicals that were released into the water. Adding to that, our coral reefs are already facing threats due to pollution, and this incident would worsen the negative ramifications on our coral ecosystems.
But so far we have seen about 21 turtles and almost like 16 dolphins dead by now. These are endangered species, and it is very sad that about 6 different species of turtles are among them, and also about 3 different dolphins. The impacts to them is very serious.
Owing to the ecological damages that are prevailing, our fishing communities are experiencing major distress. The fishing activities are temporarily suspended due to the risk of marine debris and the concerning amounts of dead fish, sea turtles, and other marine animals washing ashore. This has also caused people to avoid the purchase of fish.
The fishermen at the moment don't have any income, although the government have agreed to give 5,000 rupees. 5,000 is nothing for them. So definitely the people who are fishing very near to the ship wreck will have a longer term disasters, because it is not easy to go and catch, because I was told that some of the fish is not there.
The repercussions that we have to face due to this accident are predominantly long term, as the cleaning process of the washed up nurdles is a very time consuming and arduous process. These nurdles can get stuck inside mangroves, be buried under sand, and can get stuck under every crevice, making it impossible to track every single pellet. Since these nurdles are buoyant and can float on water, they can travel hundreds of kilometers away to different coastal areas of our island. The plastic nurdles that cannot be removed will take 500 to 1,000 years to decompose and will continue to pollute the environment for centuries to come. The oil spill that could occur within our waters is another major cause for concern, as it would worsen the damage that is already being done to our marine and coastal environments. It is assumed that the sunken ship is currently carrying 300 metric tons of fuel oil, and the Marine Environment Protection Authority continues to detect for any oil spills. Although oil spills have not yet been detected, the likelihood of the oil tanks being compromised is high due to any strains and corrosion that occur. Under the direction of the Government of Sri Lanka, the South Asia Cooperative Environment Program has requested assistance from International Maritime Organization, who are experts in oil spill contingency. As the disaster has already taken place and we have no control over the current situation, we can all only contribute to improve the situation at hand. Once the coronavirus pandemic ceases, we could collectively organize beach cleanups, innovate new equipment that would aid the collection of nurdles, and try to restore our beautiful beaches to what it was before. But the thing is, we should strive to understand why these nurdles were transported in the first place. By switching up our lifestyles and avoiding the usage of at least single-use plastic, such as plastic bags, sheets, and water bottles, we could minimize the need of these nurdles. We could also eliminate the use of products in the market that include other microplastic substances, such as microbeads. These microbeads are predominantly used in beauty products, such as scrubs and face washes, and are collected into our water streams daily. Raising awareness and influencing our family and friends to make these lifestyle changes could have major positive results in protecting and conserving our environment. While urging our citizens to play an active role in protecting our motherland, we also urge relevant authorities to take necessary precautions to prevent these disasters from occurring in the future.